So, iba yung sinasabi natin na dinadivert ang usapan sa ating budget hearing. Kung nagawa po niya yan sa Senado, Madam Chair, dapat hindi natin yan pahintulutan dito sa Kamara.
You allowed her as my comment and then you will not allow... Please wait as to my comment.
Gusto mo sagutin ko, ma'am.
Yes, and yes, please, ma'am. I remind also our first persons to please act in a respectful manner. Esensya na po, hindi po kasama sa poder ninyo ang pagpa-fire ng presiding officer ng meeting na to.
I cannot fire chair, the presiding chair. So bakit?
Yes, we...
Bakit napaka one-sided nito,
no, ma'am? Po.
Dahil ba madami kayo dyan sa kabila at nag-iisa ako dito?
Madam Vice President, with due respect, you are not allowed to do that, Madam Vice President.
Yung tactics sa ganyan, na parang ano no, parang sorry for the pusit, na kapag nasusukol na ang pusit, ay nagaano ng maitim na tinta. So ayaw natin ng ganun, Madam Chair, kasi yung atin namang pinag-uusapan dito ay budget. No? So huwag naman mag-ugaling pusit ang Office of the Vice President.
Madam Chair,
hindi na po tayo matatapos.
Yan ang sinabi ko sa iyo kanina, ayaw mo maniwala sa akin eh. Aabot talaga tayo ng bukas dito. Diba? Madam Chair.
So, yes.
So, if you allow members of the House of Representatives lines like what you just said, like pusit, bakit mo ako kinu-crucify for saying a fact that somebody is convicted of child abuse sitting in the chair? Pusit? And then,
please proceed.
Makinig ka sa kanya kanina?
Absolutely.
Walang rules dito.
I decided I'll come alone, answer all of it alone. So that kung i-contempt man ninyo ako, ako lang yung papasok doon sa detention at hindi na masali yung ibang tao.
Kakapasok lang na balita. Grabe, Vice President Sara Duterte, tinakot sa Congress ng kulong. Tatanggalan daw ang OVP ng budget. Ayon sa Vice President, pinagtutulungan niyo ako. Porke marami kayo dyan sa kabila. Tapos mag-isa lang ako dito sa Congress. Tapos kino-crucify niyo pa ako. Pinapayagan niyo si Franz Castro. Tawagin ako pusit? Eh siya nga ito convicted dito. Siya dapat pinapakulong ng Congress. Babala pa ni VP Sara, aabutin talaga tayo ng bukas dito. Sige, siraan ako sa confidential fund. Di ba tinanggal niyo na yan sa budget? Huwag niyo ako tatakutin sa kulong. Hindi ako natatakot mawala ng OVP ng budget. Pinapayagan niyo bastustin ako ng kasama niyo? Tapos pag ako, bawal magsalita. Hindi na pwede?
So, Madam Chair, siguro first observation, no, yung on the budget for the 2024, yung Vice President na nagsabi, Madam Chair, na slow and low utilization. So, nakita naman natin doon sa presentation. So, yung utilization ay napakababa. Pero, syempre, comment ko lang, no, mas mabilis siya sa confidential funds. 100% in 11 days.
Madam Chair,
So, according to the utilization of the confidential and intelligence fund submitted by the COA to us, no, so we can we have here surveillance and monitoring. Sabihin ko lang, Madam Chair, no, yung purchase of information out of 125 million confidential funds in 2022, purchase of information 14 million, payment of reward 10 million, rental and other incidental expenses relative to the maintenance of safe houses 16 million, purchase of supplies 35 million, provision of medical and food aid 40 million, payment of incentives or traveling relative to confidential operations 10 million. So a total of 125 million conducted surveillance in 132 areas in 11 days. So 100% utilization. Madam Chair, I have also here a report about the notice of disallowance. According to the notice of disallowance, the COA disallowed 73,287,000 out of 125 million confidential funds used by the OVP in 2022. So this is 58.63% of the 125 million. So can you confirm, Vice President?
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, since you allowed her a snide comment, you will allow me a snide comment as well.
So my question is, can you confirm?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Diba?
Okay.
Yes, Madam Chair.
So, before you proceed, may I remind both our guests and our research
partners to refrain from your attention. Madam Chair, you did not recognize me. So, ngayon, sasabihin ko na, if you allowed her that, you allowed me a slight comment as well.
I don't recall hearing a snide comment, Madam Vice President. Ang snide comment, that's a matter of judgment. So please proceed
I would like the Secretariat to repeat the first three lines of the comment.
A point of order, Madam Chair.
Point of order, Madam Chair. Kasi parang...
So let's please proceed with the answer.
Point of order, Madam Chair, kasi parang siya yung nagpe-preside eh. Kasi inuutusan na lang sa Secretariat natin sa Committee on Appropriation.
Yes,
alam mo na
ba? Madam Vice President, please proceed with the response. There's a question. Please proceed with the response.
Madam Chair, I do not understand bakit a person convicted of child abuse is still sitting in a seat.
Point of dinadivert ang gang usapan sa ating budget hearing. Kung nagawa po niya yan sa Senado, Madam Chair, dapat hindi natin yan pahintulutan dito sa Kamara.
You allowed her a snide comment and then you will not allow
please wait
a snide comment.
Excuse me, our members and our guests.
I warn you.
Please wait.
Don't go into this rabbit hole.
Please wait to be acknowledged before you speak. Okay. So at this point, Honorable Manuel.
Madam Chair, again, it's another point of order kasi kapag may mga deliberation tayo, we should stick to the topic. Hindi pwede, Madam Chair, na dinadivert natin yung usapan para hindi natin sagutin yung tanong ng mga mambabatas natin. This is actually the best opportunity, formal proceedings, nakikita po ng publiko para malaman anong sagot ng Vice Presidente. So hindi po natin napapayagan ang ganong mga argumento na hindi naman tumutumbok na sa topic natin.
So, Madam Chair, Senator, please make your responses direct to the
point. Sige, ma'am. I will make this easy for you. What rules are we using for this budget hearing?
We have our rules.
Yes, ma'am.
Adopted by the Committee on Appropriations.
Right, okay. We searched for that rule. So, we only found the general rules. So, ma'am, we have a copy of the rules for the budget hearings.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, mas importante ang rules para sa amin. Kayo po, ang kailangan nyo lang marinig is yung acknowledgement for you to begin to speak. Yun lang po ang pinaka-importante para sa guests. Sa totoo lang po.
Yes, ma'am.
So, ang pinaka-importante, yes, you may proceed. At saka po yung adjournment, yun lang po. Yung termination po, yun ang pinaka-importante lang po. For the rules, yun ang ay importante para sa members. But we may provide the copy to you.
Yes, ma'am.
So please proceed and answer the question.
May we request a copy?
Yes, yes, absolutely. But please, there is a question. And do you want us to repeat the question? And we will not penalize you all the time.
I don't need
you can repeat the facts from the notice of disallowance.
I don't need the Honorable Franz.
Yes, Honorable Franz Castro, you may repeat your question on the notice of disallowance, I believe.
Yeah, tama, Madam Chair. So according to COA, the notice of disallowance is amounted to 73,287,000 out of 125. At ito po, Madam Chair, yung mga breakdown ng mga disallowed na mga ng mga purchases. So reward payment of 10 million, payment of rewards various goods 34.857 million, payment of rewards medicines 24.93 million, tables, chairs, desk, computer and printers 3.5 million. So ang question, Madam Chair, so yung letter A, B and C, so nakita naman natin nandoon yung sa joint circular. How about yung ito, no? How about yung mga tables, chairs, desktop, computer na umabot po ito sa 3.5 million? So, pwede bang maipaliwanag kung bakit ito pinurchase, Madam Chair?
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, I still request for the rules of the budget hearings. Okay, gusto mo sagutin ko, ma'am?
Yes, madam.
This is a hearing of the budget of 2025. Nasaan dito ang confidential funds? Yung tanong niya, confidential funds. Nasaan dito?
Honorable friends.
Ito yung continuing, ano ko pa ito, no? Continuing questions pa natin noong 2024, during the last budgets. Hindi na ipaliwanag itong 125 million na alam naman natin na wala ito sa budget ng 2022. So, ito, Madam Chair, sa rule naman natin, lahat dito tinatanong eh, no? So, according to the budget, whether it is in the past, kasi nakikita natin yung utilization noong mga budget, kahit na yung past years, ay pwede natin busisiin dito, Madam Chair. Tama ba ako, Madam Chair?
I will agree with you, the Honorable Franz Castro. You may proceed.
Yes, ma'am. Vice President. Yun yung sagot ko, ma'am. Nasaan ang topic natin dito at ang pinasubmit ninyo sa amin is the budget proposal of 2025. Where in the budget proposal of 2025 is the item confidential funds? Sa in aid of legislation nga ninyo, nakalagay nga doon sa rules ninyo, diba? The discussion should be germane to the topic. The topic is the 2025 budget proposal. But tell me,
Madam Vice President, the Honorable Franz Castro has already provided a sufficient explanation for why she asked the question. So please proceed with your answer.
Madam Chair,
it's a very
why are we
question.
Discussing the budget of 2023 and 2024? Honorable Franz Castro.
So kung ayaw niya sagutin, Madam Chair, so let me go through na lang with my question kasi related naman ito. Remember, Madam Chair, kinwestiyon natin ito noong last year at yung 125 million na ito ay hindi ito maipaliwanag, no? Dahil nga confidential eh, no? Nagtago sa word na confidential. At ngayon, kailangan nating maipaliwanag at it is in the interest of the people. Yung 125 million na ito, Madam Chair, kaya kailangan ito na mabusisi at kailangan ito maipaliwanag ng OVP. Kaya hindi tayo pwedeng questionin ng mga rules, questionin ng mga topic, etc. Dahil related din naman talaga ito sa budget. Madam Chair.
Yes, you may proceed.
I request that the chairperson of the Finance Committee preside over this hearing.
Madam Vice President, with due respect, you are not allowed to do that, Madam Vice President. You are not allowed to introduce any motion. You are a research person this hearing, Madam President.
I requested.
So the chairperson of the committee, Madam Vice President, just please answer the question. The issue on confidential funds falls squarely within our discussion of your 2025 budget.
Narinig mo yung sinabi niya, ma'am?
Narinig mo yung sinabi
ka sa kanya kanina?
Absolutely.
Walang rules dito.
Please proceed and answer the question. It's a very simple question.
Diba?
Please explain the specific spending on those items that she enumerated amounting to a total of Honorable Franz, do you want to repeat that?
A total of 73.287 million. So, dahil may notice of disallowance, so ibig sabihin, Madam Chair, illegal ito at not in accordance with the joint circular by the COA, DDM, and other related agencies. So kung ito ay dinisallow, so ibig sabihin, illegal yung paggamit nito. Madam Chair, itong mga items na binanggit ko po, Madam Chair.
You cannot allow a member of the House to just claim that it is illegal. Pero sa notice of disallowance, that is a procedure inside the Commission on Audit, hindi sa upuan niya.
Honorable Friends.
Okay, thank you, Madam Chair. So, thank you for the explanation, Vice President. Okay, next. According to accomplishment report of OVP, it spent 10 million for payment of reward. So, Madam Chair, in 11 days, ilang tao kaya at magkano kada tao ang reward? In fact, COA disallowed the whole amount spent by OVP for payment of reward. Hindi ba, Madam Chair, questionable ito?
why don't share the invitation letter that we received from the House of Representatives. Dear Vice President Duterte, the House Committee on Appropriations will hold briefings, hearings on the budget proposals of various departments, agencies, and corporations relative to the fiscal year 2025 National Expenditure Program as the basis of the fiscal year 2025 General Appropriations Bill. Saan? Sa presentation ko kanina, ang haba, ang confidential funds.
Honorable Franz Castro.
Madam Chair, point of order lang ulit, Madam Chair. Kasi kailangan lang nating ma-establish. I would assume hindi naman po pinanganak kahapon ng ating resource person. Practice po natin sa House.
Madam Chair, this is my remark.
Na para po tayo ay makapagtalakay ng budget na pinopropose para sa susunod na fiscal year, chine-check natin paano din gumagastos yung mga ahensya even in the current year and in the past year. Also, Madam Chair, Section 162, Rulings as Precedents, rulings on questions raised by members shall form part of the parliamentary practice of the House. At practice po natin since time immemorial na hindi lang po ang proposed budget yung tinatalakay. Kasi yung performance ay dapat bahagi din ng discussion. Yun lang, Madam Chair.
Noted. Honorable Franz, could you kindly check if your mic works?
Okay. Thank you, Madam Chair. So yun po, no, yung sinasabi natin kanina, yung payment ng reward, the resource person can answer this. Questionable. Tingin ko ay questionable ito. Okay? So, next, according to the accomplishment report, isa sa pinaggamitan ng OBP ng confidential funds ay yung provision of medical and food aid. This is not allowed under the Joint Circular Number 2015-01 dahil kailan pa naging confidential fund ang pagbibigay ng ayuda. Or, kung ito naman ay ginamit sa mga ginamit na tao or informant in 11 days. So, paano kaya ginamit itong 40 million na ito, no, para sa medical and food aid in 11 days, Madam Chair? So yun yung tanong ko. Kung dito ginamit doon sa mga aids, medical aid or food aid, pero paano kaya, Madam Chair, ginamit itong 40 million na ito as a medical and food aid ng ilang tao in 11 days? So, yun po yung tanong natin, Madam Chair.
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, the subject of this hearing is the OBP 2025 budget proposal. We do not have an item of confidential funds in the OBP budget proposal.
Honorable Branch. So, I continue, Madam Chair. Isa sa bumubukol na confidential fund ng OBP noong 2022 ay nasabi ko na, Madam Chair, yung medical and food aid at saka yung mga purchase of supplies. According to the accomplishment report, the OBP spent 40 million now for medical and food aid in 11 days. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, Madam Chair, konting math, pumapatak na 3.64 million kada araw ang gastos, no, para sa food and medical aid. So, hindi natin maintindihan, Madam Chair, paano ito ginastos in 11 days, no? 3.64 million kada araw dito sa item na ito.
Madam Vice President.
Comment?
Madam Vice President.
I did not call you, ma'am. It was Representative Arroyo who called you.
The chair would like to remind both the resource persons and the members to please wait to be acknowledged before you speak.
Yes, ma'am.
So, yes. To respond.
So, any comment, Madam Chair, dun sa sinabi natin based dun sa accomplishment report. So, kung gagamitan natin ng konting math, 3.64 million kada araw ang gastos para sa medical and food for 11 days. For how many people ba itong ito?
Madam Chair, the topic and the invitation of the House of Representatives to the Office of the Vice President for this hearing is the 2025 budget proposal. There is no confidential funds in the 2025 budget proposal.
For the information of the body, the letter that we sent our Madam Vice President reads as follows. In the second paragraph, we noted the following topics to be discussed. Item number 3 is comparative budget allocation and utilization rate from fiscal year 2019 to 2023. That's item number 3. So I can provide you copies of the letter. So clearly, confidential funds spent in 2022 falls squarely within that. So yes, Honorable Francie, may proceed.
Yes, Madam Chair. So mukhang hindi na tayo sasagutin ng ating Vice President. So sa bawat sagot kasi na ganyan ng ating Vice President, for the record, since ayaw magpaliwanag ang BP, so ibig sabihin nito, yung paggastos ng 125 million ay na pera ng taong bayan ay hindi maipaliwanag. So, yun lang, Madam Chair, kaya hinihiling natin sa Vice President o OVP na kailangan na maipaliwanag itong mga sinasabing item dito. Anyway, Madam Chair, sa kanila naman ang galing, no, yung utilization at confidential and intelligence fund. And of course, ito lang naman ang hawak ko din dito, yung notice of disallowance. Kaya gusto talaga nating maintindihan, Madam Chair, kung ang notice of disallowance ay, so syempre, papaliwanag pa nila yan. Kung paano, di ba? So, kailangan malaman din ng taong bayan na sila yung nagbibigay ng pondo para sa operations ng OVP at lahat ng mga agency. At kailangan yung may paliwanag. So, hindi pwede yung ganyan na yung tactics na ganyan na parang, parang sorry for the pusit, na kapag nasusukul na ang pusit ay nagaano ng maitim na tinta. So, ayaw natin ng ganun, Madam Chair, kasi yung atin namang pinag-uusapan dito ay budget. No? So, huwag naman mag-ugaling pusit ang Office of the Vice President.
Madam Chair, may I point of information only, Madam Chair? May I? Madam Chair?
Before we proceed to the next person on the list, I believe that our former president, Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, would like to interject.
Observation made in relation to the point of order, because in the beginning, it was settled that the issue would be the 2025 budget. And in all our hearings, to what I recall, when we want to question something about performance, we question the 2024 budget. Not the 2023 budget. What is being questioned now is the 2023 budget, which was discussed very extensively last year. And that is the reason why the House removed the confidential funds. So that issue has already been, to my mind, for purposes of the budget hearing, laid to rest. So that's my observation, Madam Chair.
We know that, Madam former President, but of course we know that yung pumpondo ng 2023 ay, of course, pwede pa rin maging continuing appropriation hanggang 2024. So, in the same way, 2022 pwede maging continuing pa rin 2023. At alam din po natin, last year, pinagdebatihan po natin ng matindi itong 2022 confidential funds. And in fact, we left a homework for the COA. Sinabi natin sa kanila na kailangan nilang tapusin ang audit by November, I believe mid-November of last year. And since then, hindi na natin alam kung ano nangyari. So that's the reason for why tinatalakay natin ito. And it's a big amount of money. I believe we owe it to the people to understand what happened. Of course, tinanggal na natin noong 2024. Gusto natin malaman, tama pa yung ginawa natin? Kasi baka naman nagkamali tayo. So, I think it's worth assessing what we did in 2024 in order to know what to do in 2025. So with that, let's proceed with our next
interpreter. May I?
Is this just a point of order?
Not a point of order, but
unless it's a point of order, you may wish to be listed. I can put you here, sir.
Parliamentary inquiry, Madam Chair.
Yes, you
parliamentary inquiry. May I ask if the resource person is required to answer a question that is related to a commission on audit notice of disallowance? When she already said she's not going to answer. Also, the notice of disallowance is addressed to the Office of the Vice President. And just to make it clear, a notice of this allowance is not a judgment. It is a request. It is an order from the Commission on Audit for the particular office to explain what are the particulars. At saka hindi na yan legislation side. That is already on the accountability side in the budget cycle. So, my parliamentary inquiry, Madam Chair, is that nagsabi na nga siya na hindi siya sasagot, and it is related to the COA notice of disallowance. And just what sinabi na rin ni former President, it was thoroughly discussed in the previous year. In fact, tinanggal sa budget ng 2024 yung confidential fund. And we know that there's a pending case on that also. To discuss that further might somehow prejudice or be biased whatsoever. So, yun lang po, Madam Chair.
Alright, salamat. On your inquiry, the only requirement is to provide a direct response on the question. Meaning to say, a response that is directly related to the question. Meaning to say, kung may question at ayaw niyo pong sagutin, sagutin doon ang diretsahan na hindi po ako sasagot dun sa tanong. Ang problema po kasi, ang response ay naging hindi related dun sa tanong. Halimbawa, may tanong, ang sagot ay paglalarawan dun sa nagtanong. So, hindi naman yun klaro na hindi yun directly related dun sa tanong. Kaya, yun po, I think it's a reasonable ask. If there's a question, you may or may not answer. You're not compelled. But you just please say, I do not wish to answer. That's it. And at least we know it's a direct response. And with that, we move to the next
Madam Chair.
Person on the list.
Madam Chair.
This,
Madam Chair.
Hindi na po tayo matatapos.
Yan ang sinabi ko sa iyo kanina. Ayaw mo maniwala sa akin eh. Aabot talaga tayo ng bukas dito. Diba? Madam Chair.
Is this an inquiry regarding
what he said?
Yes, and
yes,
please,
ma'am.
I remind also our first persons to please act in a respectful manner. Esensya na po, hindi po kasama sa poder ninyo ang pagpa-fire ng presiding officer ng hearing na to.
So, yes, so if you allow members of the House of Representatives lines like what you just said, like pusit, bakit mo ako kinu-crucify for saying a fact that somebody is convicted of child abuse sitting in the chair? The seat, and then I cannot fire
there
the presiding chair. So bakit?
Yes, we
bakit napaka one-sided nito
na po?
Dahil ba madami kayo dyan sa kabila at nag-iisa ako dito?
Madam Chair, may I explain?
Yes, Honorable Franz Castro.
So, yung sinabi ko po, Madam Chair, kanina on the comment on the notice of the disallowance worth 73.287 million, sinabi ko po, ito po ay illegal in accordance with the joint circular. Tama naman po, no? Kasi hindi ito umuugma, tumutugma doon sa mga letters according to the joint circular. So, yun po yung tinutukoy ko, Madam Chair. Hindi ko naman sinasabing, wala naman po akong binanggit na final na ito. No? Kasi sinabi lang natin na hindi ito in accordance with the joint circular, Madam Chair. Thank you po.
And to Honorable Alvarez, is that the statement that you wish to be stricken off the record?
Yeah, with the ones that said that it's illegal because the notice of disallowance, the office of any office, any government office has the right to appeal the decision of the COA, and before the exit conference on the appeal could be formulated, there is nobody guilty of any offense. Your
I second the motion, Madam Chair.
Madam Chair, was it objected to, the motion of Representative Alvarez? Kasi we can only go proceed with the voting if there
is there any objection? Is there any objection to the motion of the Honorable Alvarez?
Yes, I'd like to explain the objection.
Yes, please, the Honorable
I think nasa ano na po 'yon, nasa task ng ating committee secretariat to accurately quote and put kung ano talaga ang nasabi ng ating colleague. So, 'yun na po ang magiging batayan, and it's up to the members of the House and the public to appreciate kung ano yung mga nasabi. But I believe that the topic is really connected to our discussion right now, which is how the OVP used its budget and how it will use its future budget, Madam Chair.
Wow. 1 minute suspension while we produce a transcript so I can read the exact statement. Right, 1 minute suspension.
Ngayon, ikaw, bilang Pilipino, ano ang masasabi mo at reaksyon sa balitang ito? Mag-iwang ka ng komento sa ibaba at atin pong babasahin isa-isa.